My daddy is an engineer. My brother drives a hack. My sister takes in washing, and the baby balls a jack. And it looks like I'm never gonna cease my wandering. I've been wandering early and late, New York City to the Golden Gate. And it looks like I'm never gonna cease my wandering. Toiling every day in the rain and snow, as slowly down the highway of life I go, till at last I reach that final bend. Lord, when's it gonna end? I've been working in the army, working on the farm, and all I've got to show for it is a muscle in my arm. And it looks like I'm never gonna see my wandering. And it looks like I'm never gonna cease my wandering.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. You know, we're coming into the Christmas season, and it's a time for friends to get together. We've invited some friends of ours, including you, to visit us at our home so we can all start getting into the Christmas spirit. I always enjoy showing a city boy the country, and I'm about to do that with my good friend Tony Orlando. I'm going to saddle up old paint, old red paint, that is, and show Tony a little part of Tennessee. I think you're going to enjoy it. Well, Tony, I'm sure glad you could find the time to come down and see us. I think you're going to really like the farm.
Like, I love it already, John. This is beautiful, really beautiful. You know, this is the first time I've ever ridden on a tractor. I didn't realize they'd go this fast.
Well, the plow slows it down a little bit. Look at the color in those hills over there. It's really beautiful out here this time of the year.
Yeah, it's incredible, John. By the way, did you and June decorate all those trees? The red ones and the yellow ones?
Well, we had a little help from Mother Nature.
Yeah, I love nature. Too bad it's all outdoors.
Well, you're going to get a chance to get better acquainted with it out here in the country. I just want you to make yourself at home, though, while you're here, and just feel free to wander around whenever you want to.
Well, thank you, John, very much. You make me feel that way already. You really do. But I don't know about walking around in the woods, John. I mean, there's a little danger of stepping on a snake, isn't there? And I have a thing about snakes.
Well, I don't know. If you run into a snake, bring it on home. June cooks the best snake and potatoes you ever saw.
Snake and potatoes, huh?
Well, there it is, Tony. Welcome to the farm.
Did you say a snake and potatoes, John?
Hi, June.
Hi.
it's
Tony,
good to see you.
Welcome.
Thank
oh,
you.
We're just so glad you could make it.
Why, thank you, ma'am. How's that?
You know, we want you to be at home. We want you to feel good, and I'm cooking you something inside.
Oh, well, June, I'm not very hungry, June. Honest, I'm full.
Oh, think you could find room for a little chicken fried poke salad?
Oh, poke salad? Poke salad.
No, poke salad.
Oh, poke salad.
Would you believe country ham and biscuits?
That sounds good to me.
Hey, what do you say? Come on, let's take a walk and work up an appetite, and I'll show you around, huh?
I always figured Johnny Cash would live in a rugged log cabin with a well in the front yard.
Oh, that's Elvis you're thinking about.
You know, Tony, I know you're a city boy and all, but I know, too, that you're familiar with that.
Oh, that? Of course. That's a tree.
What kind of a tree?
Oh, well, that's a big tree.
What kind of a big tree?
It's a real big tree.
Well, maybe this will help.
Oh, I know that species, that category, that family. That's of the yellow ribbon category area.
You're pretty close.
John, Tie Yellow Ribbon is my prison song. You should do some prison songs. You know, it's done very well for me.
We're coming home, we've done our time. Now I've got to know what is and isn't mine.
If you receive my letter telling you I'd soon be free,
then you'll know just what to do if you still want me.
If you still want me.
Here we go.
Tie a yellow ribbon around the old tree.
It's been 3 long years. Do you still want me?
If I don't see a ribbon around the old tree,
I'll stay on the bus. Forget about us.
Put the blame on me. If I don't see a yellow ribbon round the old tree.
Bus driver, please look for me. Cause I couldn't bear to see what I might see.
Well, I'm really still in prison, and my love, she holds the key.
A simple yellow ribbon's all I need to set me free.
I wrote and told her, please,
sit tie a yellow ribbon round the old tree.
It's been 3 long years, do you still want me?
If I don't see a ribbon round the old tree,
I'll stay on the bus.
Forget about us.
Put the blame on me.
If I don't see a yellow ribbon round the old tree.
Oh, Mr. Cash, talk to me.
Now the whole darn bus is cheering.
I hear you. Cause they can't believe what they see. Guess what that is?
100 yellow ribbons round the old tree.
Oh, goodness, let's go have some coffee.
I'd love it.
Okay.
Bye, John.
This farm you see here means a lot to me. It's a place that I can come and be with my thoughts, you know, kind of get back to my roots. And my thoughts, especially at this time of the year, naturally seem to drift toward home back in Dias, Arkansas. That's where I was raised. And looking back on those days, it makes me realize just how fortunate I am to have what I have today, my family, and a place like this. But you know, there were times in my life that I didn't have it quite so good. One day near Christmas, when I was just a child, Mama called us all together, and Mama tried to smile. She said, you know, the cotton crop hadn't been too good this year. There's just not a lot of money, but at least we're all here. I hope you won't expect a lot of Christmas presents. Just be thankful that we've all got plenty to eat. That's quite a blessing, and it'll help make things a little more pleasant. And all us kids got to thinking how really blessed we were. At least we were all healthy, but best of all, we had her. Daddy brought some hickory nuts, and Louise made the bread. Reba decorated the tree with popcorn strings before we went to bed. Mama and Daddy sacrificed that year because Christmas was lean. After all, there were the babies, Joanne and Tommy. And babies need a few things. I whittled a whistle for my brother Jack, and though we fought now and then, when I gave Jack that whistle, he knew I thought the world of him. Mama made the girls' dresses out of flour sacks, and when she ironed them down, you couldn't tell that they hadn't come from town. A sharecropper family across the road didn't have it as good as us. They didn't even have a light that Christmas night, and it was way past dusk. So me and Jack took a jar of coal oil and some more hickory nuts that we had found. We walked over to the sharecropper's porch and set them down. A poor old ragged lady eased open the door. She picked up the coal oil and hickory nuts and said, "I sure do thank you." And she quickly closed the door. We started back home, me and Jack, and about halfway we stopped and looked back. And in that sharecropper's window, at last there burned a light. So for one of our neighbors and for us, it was a good Christmas night. Christmas came and Christmas went. Christmas that year was heaven sent. Daddy put on his gum boots and we warmed and we waited for the thaw. Back home, when we were all together, that year at Christmas in Dias, Arkansas. You know, Roy Clark and I have been friends for a good many years, and he's been up the farm here many times with us.
One thing I want to know, John, is how come you never offered me any snake and potatoes?
We save that for our city friends like Tony.
I see. You know, it's something that's always struck me funny. When we were kids, we couldn't wait till we grew up and got off the farm. And now, we can't wait till we get back.
Yeah, but you know, it makes a lot of difference when you don't have to do the chores.
You know, with portable radios today, John, the kids can be plowing the South 40 and listening to the Top 40 at the same time.
I used to listen to the radio every chance I got. And I wonder, why is it that some people act surprised when they learn that we grew up listening to the same music that the rest of America listened to?
I know exactly what you mean. We used to listen to Frank Sinatra, Glenn Miller, and the Hit Parade.
Of course, country was always my first love, but I heard Bing Crosby, Peggy Lee, Nat Cole.
You know, I bet you remember the same songs that I do.
Bet I do.
Far away places with strange sounding names. Far away over the sea. Those far away places with strange sounding names are calling, calling me.
They call a dreamer. Well, maybe I am, but I know that I'm burning to see
those far away places with a strange sound.
I bet you don't remember this one, John. Oh, mopping up a soda pop, Ricky, to our heart's delight. Dancing with the first thing a real quickie. Jukebox Saturday night.
You're absolutely right. I never heard that. Where'd you get it?
You try to forget it. You know, John, just think, jukeboxes. And you know what the kids in our old hometowns are playing on the jukeboxes nowadays?
I sure do. Tony Orlando records. Here's a song I sang in a talent contest when I was about 16. Up in the morning, out on a job, work like the devil for my pay, while that lucky old son got nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. Fuss with my woman, toil for my kids, sweat till I'm wrinkled and gray, while that lucky old son got nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. Good Lord above, can't you see I'm pining? Tears all in my eyes. Send down that cloud with a silver lining. Lift me to paradise. Oh, show me that river. Take me across. Wash all my troubles away. Like that lucky old son, give me nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. You know, there are a lot of those Christmas songs that are like memory things too. Every time you hear them,
right,
you think about something nice that happened when you were a kid or the old folks at home or something.
This, I think, is one of the most beautiful Christmas songs ever written.
Chestnuts roasting by an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the seasons bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded with lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Let me see if I got this right.
where we were before is Johnny's farm, right?
Right.
Hey, Tony, see how quick you're picking up? That's 40 miles from here. This is John and June's home.
This is where I live, huh?
Incredible. This is really incredible.
Seriously,
you should see this, folks. It's unbelievable. I've been dying to ask you this question.
What's that?
What ocean is that?
That's not an ocean, Tony. That's Old Hickory Lake.
Now I know what to get him for Christmas.
What's that?
A submarine.
When he has nothing to do, he can go out and torpedo his own duck.
Nah, I wouldn't do that. Let's forget about the submarine. It's time to start thinking about Christmas, right? It doesn't look like it, but it's just about Christmas
time. It feels like Christmas here at your house, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. Well, I'm mighty glad you're both here, really. And I think we made the right choice on the songs we're going to sing. What could be more appropriate singing the songs of a man from the North who wrote such great things about the South, Stephen Foster.
Indeed.
Camp Town ladies sing the song, do-da, do-da. Camp Town racetrack 5 miles long, oh, do-da-day.
Well, I came down here with my hat caved in, do-da, do-da.
I go back home with pocket full of tin,
oh, do-da-day. Going to run all night, going to run all day.
I'll bet my money on a bobtail nag,
somebody bet on the day.
Starlight and dewdrops are waiting for thee. Sounds of the rude world heard in the day, lulled by the moonlight, all passed away. Beautiful dreamer, queen of my song, list while I woo soft melody. Gone are the cares of life's busy throng. Beautiful dreamer, wake unto me. Beautiful dreamer, wake unto me.
Bet my money on a bobtail nag,
somebody bet on the bay.
Way down up on the Swanee River, far, far away, there's where my heart is turning ever, there's where the old folks stay. Somebody bet on the bay.
around the hill.
They'll never get you
the buckwheat cakes were in her mouth, she was in her eyes. She said, I've come from the South, Susanna, don't you cry.
Oh, Susanna, don't you cry for me. I come from Alabama with the banjo on my knee. I'll soon be in New Orleans, and then I'll look around. And when I find Susanna, I'll fall upon the ground. But if I do not find her, this man will surely die. And when I'm dead and buried, oh, Susanna, don't you cry. Oh, Susanna, oh, don't you cry for me. I come from Alabama with a banjo on my knee. Oh, Susanna, now don't you cry for me. Cause the sun shines bright on my old Kentucky home with a banjo on my knee.
When June and I heard that Billy Graham and his wife Ruth were coming, we got a lot of our family and friends together for what we call a guitar pulling. What that means is everybody kind of sits around and chips in with whatever they do best, you know, whether it's playing music or singing a song or telling a story. John Carter, you go over there, son. Along with our family, we have here tonight Barbara Mandrell, Merle Travis, Tommy Cash, Jen Howard, the Tennessee Three, my mother and daddy, our daughters, Roseanne, Kathy, Carlene, our grandson, our granddaughter. Did I forget anybody, June?
Helen and Anita.
Helen and Anita?
Yeah, yeah. And then think about it, John.
Give me a hint.
Well, the key word is Mrs.
No, I said Mrs. Graham.
John R. Cash.
Oh, I'm sorry. Mrs. John R. Cash.
That's right.
Okay, John Carter, your mother is going to sing, son. From Gospel Road, a John Denver song called Follow Me.
Follow me where I go, what I do and who I know. Make it part of you to be a part of me. Follow me up and down, all the way, all around. Take my hand and say you'll follow me. You see, I'd like to share my life with you and show you things I've seen, places where I'm going to, places where I've been, to have you there beside me and never feel alone. And all the time that you're with me, we could be alone. Follow me where I go, what I do and who I know. Make it part of you to be a part of me. Follow me up and down, all the way, all around. Take my hand and say you'll follow me.
Thank you.
Chances are, Merle Travis has influenced more country guitar players than any other man. My memories of Merle Travis go way back a long way. First, I was a big fan of his, like I am now. Later, we met and we became friends and worked a lot of tours together. And for the last 4 years, Merle Travis has been nominated to the Country Music Hall of Fame. And Merle, I got a feeling that next year is your year to make it.
Well, it don't hurt the dream, John.
Well, it's your pull on the guitar, Merle. What are you going to pull for us?
Oh, I might pick you a couple little tunes, John.
Merle Travis guitar. Thank you. fine, Merle. Thanks. Well, a show like this wouldn't be complete without a song from my brother, Tommy Cash. Tommy's been a member of our touring show now for a year or more. Tommy, what you got? Listen, you want to do a song with us?
Yeah, you do a song with me, too.
I'd love to. What do you
that
got?
That Christmassy feeling. This is a happy time of the year.
Christmassy feeling. All right.
Well, there's happiness in my heart. Christmas is on its way. With the family all back together again. Oh, what a happy day. Well, I hope it snows and the north wind blows. My boy wants a little toy train. We've got that Christmassy feeling again. Singing joy to the world. And here comes Santa Claus. Mama's baking turkey.
And Daddy's making popcorn balls.
Sisters hanging mistletoe.
It's goodwill to all men. I've got that Christmassy feeling again. Singing joy to the world. And here comes Santa Claus.
Mama's baking turkey.
And Daddy's making popcorn balls.
And sisters hanging mistletoe.
It's goodwill to all men. I've got that Christmassy feeling again. I've got that Christmassy feeling again. That's good.
That's really nice.
Thank you.
With just two words, I found myself associated with a country music legend, the legend of the Carter family. And those two words were, I do.
I do.
I can't imagine anybody being prouder of his in-laws than I am, ladies and gentlemen, the Carter family. I once did a show with a 12-year-old girl who won an audience over with her version of Steel Guitar Rag. She's a grown-up singing star now. That was quite a while back, and she's one of the tops in our business. And she's brought along her steel guitar tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, here's our friend Barbara Mandrell.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you. Hey, Barbara, thanks a lot for bringing along that steel guitar.
Thank you.
Thanks for bringing back a nice memory, too.
Yes, thank you.
And now it's time for you to sing, will you?
I'd love to sing. This is a new one, John. It's called It's a Beautiful Morning with You.
It's Barbara Mandrell.
We've got a kitchen and a bed, that's all. We share a bathroom with the folks down the hall. There's a hole in the roof, rain's leaking through. Still, it's a beautiful morning with you. Don't have a TV or a radio. Kitchen sink's about to overflow. The faucet's broke and we are too. Still, it's a beautiful morning with you. It's a beautiful morning with you. It's a beautiful morning with you. Though there's so many reasons for feeling blue, still it's a beautiful morning with you. Our cupboard looks mighty big. Can't even buy a ribbon for my hair. Just got a letter from the Internal Revenue. Still, it's a beautiful morning with you. It's a beautiful morning with you. It's a beautiful morning with you. Though there's so many reasons for feeling blue, still, it's a beautiful morning with you. Though there's so many reasons for feeling blue, still it's a beautiful morning with you. It's a beautiful morning with you. It's a beautiful morning with you. Though there's so many reasons for feeling blue, still it's a beautiful morning with you.
Well, you know, a show like this certainly wouldn't be complete if June and I didn't do a love song. What do you say, let's do one, honey?
Oh, I'd love to.
Old Time Feeling. I could lie here forever, listen to the falling rain. I didn't think I would ever be touched this way again until you came. You smiled at me and rolled away the years back to a place. There was time enough to love, love enough to give. You gave me that old time feeling. You gave me that old time feeling. We'll find a better place. Feeling that we can't erase. The rainbows that we chased will never end. We're coming close again. When your love lets me in, I don't know where I stop and you begin. You give me that old time feeling. In the early morning walking, I have you by my side. The morning breeze is blowing all the trouble from my mind. And when evening comes, we'll watch the moon ride easy in the sky. The way it used to be, that old way of loving is coming back to me. You give me that old. Coming close again when your love lets me in.
that old time feeling. You give me that old time feeling.
John, you know, my wife and I really want to express what a wonderful evening we've had here at your home among your friends and sharing their music.
Well, that's very kind of you, but I think everybody in this guitar pulling is waiting for what to me is the big moment, and that's to hear from Billy Graham, right, folks?
Well, thank you, John. I do have a little Christmas story that I could tell that maybe the children might be interested in, and maybe some of the older children as well.
We'd love to hear it.
Well, you know, I always figured that at Christmas time, it's always Christmas when a little child is born. The angels sing their song in somebody's sky, and heaven fills the atmosphere of somebody's home with its gloria in excelsis, and the message of peace on earth and goodwill among men. As Bret Hart tells a story, it happened in Roaring Camp during the Gold Rush days in old California. Peace and goodwill were almost unknown at Roaring Camp until that little baby was born. Even among the mining camps of the lawless West, Roaring Camp was known to be among the worst. When men differed in opinion over their cards, they settled the dispute by shooting each other. To die a natural death at Roaring Camp was almost unknown. There was just one woman there, poor old Sal. She was everybody's woman. During the birth of her baby that night, poor Sal died. And thus the baby belonged to the camp, and the camp decided to do its duty by the baby. The baby was lying in the rags in a box, but the men felt that the box wouldn't do. So a man was sent 80 miles on a mule train to get a rosewood cradle, the best that money could buy. The cradle was brought, but the rags seemed out of place, and the messenger had to return all the way to Sacramento for lace, regardless of the cost. But when the little baby lying amidst the lace in the rosewood cradle took his place in the middle of the room, the men noticed a thing they'd never noticed before. The floor was absolutely filthy. And when they'd scrubbed the floor and made it clean, they made a new discovery. They saw that in order to match the floor and the rosewood cradle and the lacework and the baby, the walls would have to be cleaned and the ceilings whitewashed and the windows draped with curtains. There also had to be long periods of quiet to allow the baby to sleep. And so the quality that had given Roaring Camp its name left it. One day, the men took the cradle out to the mines, but the mining area was a dusty and dreary place. So to please the baby's eye, they planted brightly colored flowers round about the spot where the cradle stood. And so the mine became a garden. Best of all, a change came over the appearance of the men themselves. Up at Tuttle's store, the owner placed mirrors round about the room in which the men lounged and chatted and smoked. And soon there was a great demand for soap and shaving materials, collars, ties, and even suits of clothes. The baby had transformed everything. The Roman world itself was a roaring camp 2,000 years ago. Men were either slave owners or slaves. Womanhood was often debased. Unwanted children were often strangled or drowned. And outside of Judaism, there was little to prevent it, and few seemed to care. Then a little child was born in Bethlehem. In the presence of that little child, men saw, as they had never seen before, that the world needed changing. The cry of the slave could not harmonize with the song of the angels, so slavery had to eventually go. The degradation of womanhood was put to shame by the Virgin Mother. A halo fell upon the brows of motherhood. And ever since that little baby was born, childhood has been treated as a more sacred thing. As the little child of Bethlehem asserts his authority over the hearts of men, the things that still disfigure our civilization could vanish one by one. The bitterness of our international strife, the vice of moral decadence, the horrors of crime, the social injustices, all of these must someday yield to His authority. As the cradle is exchanged for a cross, so someday it will have a crown. And the Bible says that every knee will bow to His authority. And certainly, as the babe of Bethlehem is the Son of God, the transformation of the world like roaring camp will be carried to completion someday. And the same is true of you as an individual. The Christ child must be born afresh in your heart. Your heart must become His inn. And angels can sing again at this Christmas season of peace and goodwill, as they sang in the fields of Bethlehem so long ago. Shepherds will come once more to see the wonders that have come to pass. Men and women transformed by His power. John, that was the little story I wanted to say to you tonight.
Wonderful. You know, you've been such a great blessing to so many millions of people. I just want to say, God bless you, Billy Graham.
Well, God bless you, and a Merry Christmas.
Thank you. John Carter, come here, son. Come here, children. You know, Christmas is a time of visiting old friends and getting together with your family. But more than that, to all of us, it is a celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ, our Lord, the Prince of Peace. May His peace live in your homes and in your hearts. This is the greatest season of the year, and I thank you for sharing a small part of it with us tonight for my family, my friends, and me. Good night and happy holidays. Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. Good evening. Good evening. Hello, Bill Walker. Hi, Mama. Thank you. Christmas time's coming. Christmas time's coming. Christmas time's coming, and I know I'm going home. Snowflakes falling, old home's calling, tall pines are humming. Christmas time's coming. Can't you hear them bells ringing, ringing? Joy, joy, hear them singing. When it's snowing, I'll be going back to my country home. Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, and I know I'm going home. White candles burning, my old heart's yearning for the old folks at home when Christmas time's coming. Can't you hear them bells ringing, ringing? Joy, joy, hear them singing. When it's snowing, I'll be going back to my country home. Holly's in the window, home is where the wind blows. Can't walk for running, Christmas time's coming. Can't you hear them bells ringing, ringing? Joy, joy, hear them singing. When it's snowing, I'll be going back to my country home. Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, and I know I'm going home. Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming.
Johnny Cash Christmas Show from Nashville, starring Johnny Cash with special guest star Roy Clark, and also starring June Carter Cash the Carter family, Jerry Lee Lewis, Roy Orbison, Carl Perkins, and the Statler Brothers.
You know, thank you very much. You know, it seems that as soon as Thanksgiving is over, the Christmas season begins. Well, that's the way it is with our show tonight, the beginning of the Christmas season, and of that, of the Christmas spirit for all of you, we hope. I'm going to tell you about some of the most important Christmases in my life in Germany, in Memphis, in Canada, in Israel. But right now, I'd like you to meet the best Christmas present I ever had, June Carter Cash.
Oh, I'm telling you, thank you. Isn't it it's the best time of the year. Really
is. Oh, it
is.
Sure is. You know, it's a time when folks think of home.
And presents.
And of their favorite Christmas carols.
And gifts.
And of trimming the tree.
And what's under the tree?
Hey, you know what? I get the feeling that you're trying to tell me something, June.
No, that's not it, really. I just was trying to ask you something.
Oh, what was that?
What'd you get me for Christmas?
I'll tell you what, I'll take you Christmas shopping, June, all right?
Well, that's a deal. If you'll
sing a song with me,
I'd like to.
Let's do
what? We'll do that.
Darling companion, come on and give me understanding.
Let me be your champion, the hand to hold your pretty hand in.
Darling companion,
now you know you'll never be abandoned.
Love will always light our landing.
I can depend on you. A little saucy mare like you should a heavy steed.
Oh, a little riding down from you is what I need.
Darling companion, now you know you'll never be abandoned. Love will always light our landing. I can depend on you. Don't hurt yourself, Mama.
Darling companion, come on and give me understanding.
Long as we keep laughing, bear in mind just what can happen.
Darling companion, I tell the mountains and the canyons, long as I got legs to stand on, I'm gonna stick by you.
Oh, a little saucy mare like you should have a steed. I tell the mountains and the canyons, as long as I got legs to stand on, I'm gonna stick by you. Christmas memories, I've had a lot of them. A Christmas that changed my life came when I was 20 years old. I was in the Air Force in Germany. I was lonesome, homesick, and I had no idea what I wanted to do with the rest of my life. But one day I walked 4 miles through the snow to a little pawn shop where there was a guitar in the window with a $5 price tag. And although I didn't know it then, my life started to change. I started with 3 chords that a buddy taught me, and I took an old folk song and started to try to learn to accompany myself on the guitar. The first one I learned was C. Jimmy cracked corn and I don't care. Number 2 chord was G7. Jimmy cracked corn and I don't care. Back to C. Jimmy cracked corn and I don't care. And there's F, that's the biggie, the hard one. The master's gone away. I spent 3 years in Germany and my main contact with the American music I love so much came from Armed Forces Radio. A big hit in America then was Rosemary Clooney's This Old House. It was a big hit in our barracks, too, and the Statler Brothers and the Tennessee Three are going to help me show you what it was like. We're going to recreate that time and that mood. This old house once knew my children. This old house once knew my wife. This old house was home and comfort as we fought the storms of life. This old house once rang with laughter. This old house heard many shouts. Now she trembles in the darkness when the lightning walks about.
But I ain't gonna need this house any longer. Ain't gonna need this house any longer.
Ain't got time to fix the shingle. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the same. This old house is getting shaky. This old house is getting old. This old house lets in the rain. This old house lets in the cold. Oh, my knees are getting chilly, but I feel no fear of pain. Cause I see an angel beating through a broken window pane.
Now my old hound dog lies asleep and he don't know I'm gonna leave. Else he'd wake up by the fireplace and he'd sit there and howl and scream. But my hunting days are over, ain't gonna hunt the coon no more. Gabriel just brought in my chariot when the wind blew down the door. But I ain't gonna need this house no longer, ain't gonna need this house no longer.
Ain't got time to fix the shingle, ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, I'm getting ready to meet the same.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer, ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time, ain't got time, ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer, I'm getting ready to meet the same.
You know, I had some good times in the service, but I didn't really know what lonely was until Christmas time came around overseas, thousands of miles away from home, and I missed home. Missed my family and a young lady or two.
Do you remember who they were?
No, I don't. Don't remember. No, I'm not going to tell you. But there's a song that brings those memories back, and I'd like to do it.
Have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree won't mean a thing if you're not here with me. I'll have a blue, blue Christmas, that's certain. And when those blue, blue heartaches start hurting, you'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white. But I'll have a blue, blue Christmas.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue thinking about you.
Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree won't mean a thing if you're not here with me.
I'll have a blue Christmas, that's certain. And when those blue heartaches start burning,
you'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white. But I'll have a blue, blue Christmas. You know, Christmas time is a time for traditions. This is our second Christmas special, and we seem to be building a little tradition of our own right here, because Roy Clark was our special guest last year, and here he is again, Roy Clark.
Thank you. John, I want you to know one thing. I've been called a lot of things in the past, but never a tradition.
Oh, really? What have you been called?
Well, I've been called handsome, talented, versatile, slim, wavy-haired, dashing, debonair, sophisticated, cute as a button. Get back. Have I forgotten anything?
Yes, you did.
What did I forget?
Modest.
Oh, yeah. And modest.
Oh, yeah. Roy Clark.
Thank you, Josh. Thank you.
You know, Roy, in preparing the music for this show, Bill Walker and I, we were looking at the songs, and we suddenly realized that three of the biggest Christmas songs were made hits by one man.
I know what you mean. And every country music singer owes something to the original singing cowboy, Gene Autry.
That's right.
I know that someday you'll want me to want you. When I'm in love with somebody else.
And in every Christmas season, the memory of Gene Autry comes back with three gold record hits. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen, Blitzen, all his reindeers pulling on the rein. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers, Santa Claus comes tonight.
For the children,
Frosty the Snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose, and two eyes made out of coal. Frosty the Snowman is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day.
There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found. For when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around.
Frosty the Snowman was alive as he could be. And the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me.
You know, Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen,
Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen, but do you recall the most famous reindeer of all?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it blows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games.
But then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say,
Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?
Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. You'll go down in history.
Another Christmas memory. The year was 1955. The place was 706 Union Avenue in Memphis, Tennessee. The sign on the door said Sun Records, and a man named Sam Phillips ran the place. It was a small record company. It featured several young singers looking for that big break, and I was one of them. This was my first Christmas as a professional singer, and here's a song I was doing back then.
Showed the clouds out of cover up a clear blue sky, and the tears I cried for that woman gonna flood you big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota, and it tore me up every time I heard her draw, southern draw. Then I heard my dream went back downstream, cavorting in Davenport, and I followed you, big river, when you called. Then you took me to St. Louis, later on down the river. A freighter said she's been here, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found a trail in Memphis, but she just walked up the bluff. She raised a few eyebrows and went on down alone. Once you batted down the Baton Rouge, through the Queen, rolled it on. Take that woman on down to New Orleans, New Orleans. Go on, I've had enough, dump my blues down in a gulf. She loves you, big river, more than me. Yes, I taught the weeping willow how to cry, cry, cry. Showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears I cried for that woman gonna flood you, big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
Thank you. Two of the men you see here go back with me those Sundays. Marshall Grant goes back to the very beginning. Started together 22 years ago, Marshall Grant. And W.S. Holland, Fluke Holland, we call him, is another old-timer with us. Been my drummer for 19 years now. Fluke, take a bow. And starting his 10th year with us is my lead guitarist and my brother-in-law, Bob Wooten. That's the Tennessee Three. And the other two fine musicians are Jerry Hensley on guitar and Earl Ball on piano. All right. Well, you know, if there was one record that put Sun Records on the map in those early days, it was Blue Suede Shoes, written and sung first by this man right here, my friend Carl Perkins.
Thank you. Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. You can do anything but lay off of my blue suede shoe. You can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Do anything that you want to do, but not on, baby, lay off of my shoes. And don't you step on my blue suede shoe. You can do anything but lay off of my blue suede shoe. All right, let's go. car, drink my liquor from an old fruit jar. Do anything you wanna do. Baby, lay off of my shoes and don't you step on my blue suede shoe. You can do anything but lay off of my blue suede shoe. All right, let's rock. The show, free to get ready now. Go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. You can do anything but lay off of my blue suede shoe. Well, it's blue, blue, blue suede shoe. 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 Do anything but lay off of my blue suede shoe.
A close friend of mine ever since those Sun Record days is Roy Orbison. I remember one time he was kind of discouraged and came for me for advice about what to do, you know, and I said, Roy, I think you should change your name and lower your voice. Boy, was that some bad advice, because it wasn't too long until he had the biggest record in the whole wide world. It was Pretty Woman, and here is Roy Orbison. You know what they called us back in those Sun Record days? Rockabillies. One of the young men at Sun Records really typified rockabilly. On the labels of his records, they had mentioned his pumping piano, and that could only be the killer, the greatest, Jerry Lee Lewis.
Thank you, John.
you gotta do, honey, is stand that thing in one little spot. Wiggle it around a little bit, then you know what you got. Come on. Well, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. Where those treetops glisten, you know, children used to listen to hear those sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright. And may all your Christmas
Of course, there were others at Sun Records. Charlie Rich was there. So was Conway Twitty. And there was another one. In fact, after appearing at high school auditoriums and places like that, I worked my very first concert as a guest, and he was a star. And he always was a star. Because all of us remember him and how he loved gospel songs and how we liked him, this song is for Elvis. Come on, fellas, let's do it for him.
This train is bound to glory, this train. This train is bound to glory, this train. This train is bound to glory. Nobody ride it but the righteous and the holy. This train is bound to glory, this train.
This train don't care no gamblers, this train. This train don't care no gamblers, this train. This train don't care no gamblers, no crap shooters and the midnight ramblers. This train don't care no gamblers, this train.
You know this train don't care no jokers, this train. This old train, it don't care no jokers, this train. This old train, it don't care no jokers, no high-tone women, them cigar smokers, this train. I'm talking about God's train.
Yeah, this train is bound for this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory. Nobody ride it but the righteous and the holy. This train is bound for glory, this train.
This train don't care no liars, this train. This train don't care no liars, this train. This train don't care no liars, no slow walkers, midnight flyers. This train don't care no liars, this train.
Let me tell you, fellas, this train. Last train, this train.
Oh,
you hear me say this train is the last train, this train. This old train is the last train to get on board. She ain't coming back again. Oh, this train is the last train, this train.
This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound for glory, this train. This train is bound.
The most important Christmas of my life was 1968. That's the year I married June Carter. And that year, we made our first trip to the Holy Land. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child.
A trip to the Holy Land is a visit to the cornerstone of our faith. And this year we returned, first to Jerusalem and Bethlehem.
Oh,
This body of water is the Sea of Galilee, and it was to these shores that Jesus came, and this is the land of Galilee, where he went about his ministry of love and healing, healing not only the bodies, but the spirits of men as well, gathering men and women into the kingdom of heaven. Follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men, he said. And he chose for himself 12 disciples to carry on his eternal work. He preached the gospel of good news for humanity, eternal life through him. At one time, he sent forth 70 disciples as sheep among wolves, two by two.
Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send thee? I'm gonna send thee two by two, two by Paul and Silas, one by the little bitty baby who was born in Bethlehem. Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send thee? I'm gonna send thee three by three.
He said three by the Hebrew children,
and two by Paul and Silas, one by the little bitty baby who was
born in Bethlehem.
Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send thee? I'm gonna send thee six by six.
Six by six, that couldn't get it fixed.
Five by five, couldn't get by.
Four by four, they couldn't get in the door.
Six, three by the Hebrew children.
Then two by Paul and Silas. One by the little bitty baby who was
born in Bethlehem.
Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send thee? I'm gonna send thee nine by nine.
Nine by nine, the dress so fine.
Eight by eight, that's good as the game.
Seven by seven, they couldn't get it.
And six by six, they couldn't get it fixed.
Five by five, couldn't get by.
Four by four, they couldn't get in the door.
Yeah. Three by the Hebrew children.
And two by Paul and Silas. One by the little bitty baby who was
born in Bethlehem.
Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send thee? I'm gonna send thee 12 by 12.
12 by the 12 that couldn't get in.
11 by 11 that couldn't get to heaven.
10 by 10 who couldn't get in.
9 by 9 that dress all fine.
Yeah. 8 by 8 that stood at the gate.
7 by 7 that couldn't get to heaven.
6 by 6 that couldn't get a fix.
Yeah. 5 by 5 that couldn't get by.
4 by 4 that couldn't get in the door.
3 by the Hebrew children.
2 by 4 and Silas.
1 by the little bitty baby who was
born in Bethlehem.
Well, that's our show tonight, coming to you from Music City and the Holy Land. I hope you've enjoyed it. I'd like to thank our guests for being with us tonight and for doing such a great job. Hope you have a nice Christmas, and I'll see you when we all get home.
neighbor tipped his hat to me this morning. The landlord even smiled and said good day. And I want you to know, a stranger said hello. Christmas can't be far away. Old tightwad down the street is buying candy to pass out to the neighbor kids at play. The town is on the go. The weatherman said snow. Christmas can't be far away. The small fry on our block have all been saving, and now they're hiding things and looking sly. Mom will get that new dress she's been craving, and Dad will get that usual Christmas tie. Both young and old are planning sweet surprises. They'll soon be tied with ribbons bright and gay. Goodwill is in the air, you feel it everywhere. Christmas can't be far away. Christmas can't be far.
Television City in Hollywood, this is the Johnny Cash Christmas Show, starring Johnny Cash, with guest stars Rita Coolidge, Kris Kristofferson, Steve Martin, and June Carter Cash, the Carter family, and the Tennessee Three.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. Thank you. You know, thank you very much. Usually, when we do our holiday show, we get together with our family and friends in Nashville. This year, though, we're doing it just a little differently. Since five or six of our daughters now live here in California, June and I wanted to come visit them. Also, we wanted to spend time with some of our very close friends who live out here.
Hear that? Talking about friends? He's talking about me. Nah, Johnny and I are very, very, very close. And he calls me El Stevo, you know. I call him Johnny Baby. And, the Casher, I call him the Casher. Sometimes, El Casherini, I call him that. And we are close friends. I mean, I feel like sometimes we were in the army together. We weren't, but we're so close that sometimes I feel that way. And, well, sometimes before a concert, he'll call me up and he'll ask me what he should wear. And after the show, I'll call him, tell me how it went. Sometimes he'll call me the late evening, early evening. Sometimes he calls me mid-evening. Calls me sometimes in the early afternoon or the mid-afternoon. Occasionally late afternoon or the mid-early afternoon. Sometimes he calls me early morning or the mid-early morning. Call me in the late mid-early morning. Sometimes mid-mid-early morning. He never calls me at dusk. It's just some snapshots. This is me standing in front of Johnny's house. And then this is me in front of his dog. And this is his dog in front of me. But the point is, we're pals, we're buddies, we are very, very close friends. I think you know what I'm talking about.
In the audience tonight is a man who, as much as anyone I've ever known, has shown me the meaning of the word friend. A man who has brought happiness to so many people and whose presence here tonight makes me so happy. Ladies and gentlemen, my buddy, Steve Crabtree.
You know Johnny?
My friend.
What's he like? I mean, is he fun? I mean, what's he like?
Best friend I ever had.
Really? Yeah. You know him. Jeez. He knows
kills him.
He always does this to me. He hates to see me in the limelight, and that's the thing. Drives me nuts.
You know, being in Hollywood reminds me that 21 years ago, I recorded a song about a girl that came to Hollywood to become a star. And this is that song about her, Ballad of a Teenage Queen.
Dream on, teenage queen, prettiest girl we've ever seen.
There's a story in our town of the prettiest girl around. Golden hair and eyes of blue, how those eyes could flash at you.
How those eyes could flash at you.
Boys hung round her by the score, but she loved the boy next door who worked at the candy store.
Dream on, teenage queen, prettiest girl we've ever seen.
She was tops in all they said, never once went to her head. She had everything it seemed, not a care this teenage queen.
Not a care this teenage queen.
Other boys could offer more, but she loved the boy next door who worked at the candy store.
Dream on, teenage queen, you should be a movie queen.
He would marry her next spring, saved his money, bought a ring. Then one day a movie scout came to town to take her out.
Came to town to take her out.
Hollywood could offer more, so she left the boy next door working at the candy store.
Dream on, teenage queen, see you on the movie screen.
Very soon she was a star, pretty house and shining cars, swimming pool and the fence around, but she missed her old hometown.
But she missed her old hometown.
All the world was at her door, all except the boy next door who worked at the candy store.
Dream on, teenage queen, saddest girl we've ever seen.
Then one day this teenage star sold her house and all her cars, gave up all her wealth and fame, left it all and caught a train.
Left it all and caught a train.
Do I have to tell you more? She came back to the boy next door who worked at the candy store.
Now this story has some glory.
You know, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. You make me feel at home, and I really thank you very much for the reception here. My hobby is photography, and tonight I'm going to show you some of the pictures I've taken. This first one was taken in Jamaica during a recent vacation. It's a kind of a different look at one of the biggest motion picture and music stars in the world. He is also my guest tonight, Kris Kristofferson.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
I didn't know you took such good pictures.
Oh, well, sometimes. You know, Kris and his wife, Rita Coolidge, were two of the people we came to California just to be with. But when we got here, Kris was in Natchez, Mississippi, making a movie. And, Kris, I really want to thank you for flying in just to do this show. I really appreciate it very much.
I'm honored. I get to play with Tennessee 3+4 here.
Hey, let's do a song. Here's a song that Kris wrote, 10 years ago? And I sing it, and I loved it, and I've been singing it so long, I've kind of claimed it all for my own, but I would really be honored if you'd sing it with me. You mind?
Well, up to now, that was the proudest moment of my life. This might be the proudest.
Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head. That didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled in my closet, threw my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. Then I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day.
Smoked my brain the night before on cigarettes, the songs that I'd been picking. But I lit my first and watched a small kid cussing at a can that he was kicking.
Then I crossed the empty street and caught the sunny smell of someone frying chicken. Lord, it took me back to something that I lost somehow, somewhere along the way.
On the Sunday morning sidewalks, wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Cause there's something about a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk. Sunday morning coming down.
Hey, you go. You know who's going to join us now, Chris?
Who?
Steve Martin.
Oh, wow. You know, I'd really like to get to hear him sing. You know, he's such a good picker when he's serious on the banjo. I think he might have a really incredible voice.
Well, he might sing with us, but he won't sing by himself. He won't do it solo, I know. He'll sing in a group, you know, like with us, but not solo.
But now you mention it, I don't think I've ever heard him singing by himself. I heard him fooling around, you know, and singing with a group. But maybe we could trick him. We could get an old Carter song. Have him come out, join us with a song, and then at a signal, I'll signal you and we'll drop out. And then for the first time on national TV, you'll hear Steve Martin's real voice.
Singing solo. Sounds great. That's good. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Martin.
Listen, you guys want to do a song together?
Wouldn't you like to sing along?
Oh, it's more fun, I think, if all of us sing. Don't you think so?
Yeah, sure, man. Why don't, what kind would you
sing? Oh, let's all sing one together. How about an old classic like Wonder How the Old Folks Are at Home?
Wonder How the Old Folks Are.
You know that?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's sing it, all right? Well, I wonder how the old folks are at home. I wonder if they miss me when I'm gone. I wonder if they'll pray for the boy who went away and left his dear old parents all alone. I can hear the cattle lowing in the lane. I can almost see the fields of bluegrass green. I can almost hear them cry as they kiss their boy goodbye.
Bawk, 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 bawk.
Country music has become truly international. Proof of that is my next guest, the country music superstar of France. Ladies and gentlemen, Jean-Pierre Lewis.
Merci. Actually, Jenny mispronounced my name. It's not Lewis, it's Louis. L-O-U-E-Y. You know, you say Huey, Louie, and Dewey. You don't say Hughes, Lewis, and Dewey. You see, in my native France, I'm a very, very famous guy. In fact, when the people see me walking down the street, they say, "If you're so famous, how come you're walking down the street?" But I tell you something. There's a very, very good reason why I am known as the Johnny Cash of France. You see, Johnny and I have very much in common. He is known as the man in the black. In my country, I am known as the man in the brown pleated pants with the crazy tie and the tweed coat with the one button, maybe two, depending on the weather, and the Gucci belt. I've also had many big country music hits. Some of my big hits include La Boy avec Nom de Plume Sue. Translated, it's sort of a funny gag. It means the boy with a name not like you would expect, like Ralph or Ted, but instead he has a funny name, like Sue. But I'll tell you something else. One of my big hits was my big railroad song called La Speciale de la Blossome à la Orange. As a matter of fact, I'd like to do this for you right now. Here we go. Look yonder coming down the railroad track. It's La Speciale de la Blossome à la Orange. Bringing my baby back. Everybody, it's La Speciale de la Orange de Blossom. Come on, they sing. Don't you have people sing here? What's going on? Anyway, I guess you are wondering what I'm doing here in America. Well, you see, I'm part of the Cultural Exchange Program. My country sent me over here to sing my songs and travel around the country, and in exchange, they are sending to France some yogurt. And maybe some erasers, too. But I'll tell you, I'm really enjoying my visit here to America. In fact, two of my favorite stars are on the show tonight, Rita Coolidge and her husband, Calvin Coolidge. Oh, one other thing. I was going to tell you a little bit about French country music. Right now, the number one country song in France is Bad, Bad Leroy Charpentier. My time is running low now, and I would just like to say bonsoir from the man in the beige pleated pants with a tweed coat with a one or two buttons, sometimes open, sometimes not, and the Gucci belt. I'm going to go visit Johnny right now. I'm going to his place after the show to hunt for bulls. I don't understand it. He said to me, why don't you come over after the show and we'll bullshoot?
Thank you. Christmas is a time for visiting with your loved ones and friends, but for some people, it's not quite that simple. Earlier this year, I visited nursing homes, retirement centers, even went into a couple of prisons. The meaning of my next song deals with setting spirits free, because at those places, I made some friends and came to know more. A little bit more about what it can be like for people who live a confined life. We've all heard the story about the three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who were relegated to a terrible place. Well, this song is about the fourth man, the one who set their spirits free. If you're going to spend this Christmas confined for one reason or another, this song is dedicated to you. And if you're somebody who'll make that confinement a little pleasanter, someone whose visit can really make a Merry Christmas, then this song is dedicated to you too. Here is a story from the Bible that we know, a story about a miracle that happened long ago. We hope you can find courage when temptations you might meet. Oh, there's somebody watching who's strong when you're weak. They wouldn't bend.
They held on to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow the knees to the idols they adored.
They wouldn't burn.
They were protected by the
fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend. They wouldn't bow.
They wouldn't burn.
Well, the prophet Daniel tells about three men who walk with God. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, before the wicked king they stood. Now the king commanded them bound and thrown into the fiery coals that day. But the fire was so hot that the men were slain, that forced them on the way. They wouldn't bend.
They held on to the will of God, so we are told.
They wouldn't bow.
They would not bow their knees to the idols they had thrown.
They wouldn't burn.
They were protected by the
fourth man in the fire. They wouldn't bend. They wouldn't bow.
They wouldn't burn.
When the three were cast in and the king rose up to witness their awful fate, he began to tremble at what he saw, and in astonished tones he spake. Did we not cast three men bound into the midst of the fire? I believe I see four men unhurt, unbound, and walking down there. I see Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and the fiery coals they trod. But the form of the fourth man that I see is like the Son of God. They wouldn't bend.
They held on to the will of God, so we are told.
They gentlemen, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, here's my lady, June Carter Cash. I'd like to live out all my dreams, and if I could, yes, if I could, the nicest one would be with you, and you'd be here with me. Don't you ever get lonely.
Lord, I'm no good when you're away, but what can you expect from a girl who's loved you like I've loved you? Won't you ever just get tired and come on home to me? Won't you ever get lonely?
You're a part of me that I can't do without. You're a part of me the dreams are all about.
But you can't hold on to something that you've never had before. Love waits for the wind to bring you back again.
Friends say it's great now you're a star, but what can they expect from a girl who's loved you like I've loved you?
Oh, and late at night, how I wish things had never changed and you were here with me. Don't you ever get lonely.
You're a part of me that I can't do without. You're a part of me the dreams are all about.
But you can't hold on to something that you've never had before. Love waits for the wind to bring you back again and take me away. Let's sing a Christmas song. Let's bring out our friend Rita Coolidge and some fella she brought along with her here.
Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, and I know I'm going home.
Snowflakes falling, my old home's calling, tall pines are humming, Christmas time's coming. Can't you hear them bells ringing, ringing, joy, joy, hear them singing, when it's snowing, I'll be going back to my country home.
Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, and I know I'm going home.
White candles burning, my old heart's yearning for the old folks at home. Christmas time's coming.
Can't you hear them bells ringing, ringing, joy, joy, hear them singing, when it's snowing, I'll be going back to my country home.
Holly's in the window, home is where the wind blows, can't walk for a running, cause Christmas time's coming.
Can't you hear them bells ringing, ringing, joy, joy, hear them singing, when it's snowing, I'll be going back to my country home. Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, and I know I'm going home. Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, Christmas time's coming, and I know I'm going home.
Earlier, I showed you a picture I took of Chris in Jamaica, and here's a picture I took on that same trip of Chris's wife. And it's really nice, and I enjoy photography when I got a beautiful lady like this to work with. She's a wonderful singer as well. And our guest here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Rita Coolidge.
Softer. Someday these may be all we remember of each other. Please don't tell me how the story ends. Never's just the echo.
I've written a new song that I'd like to sing tonight because it's a Christmas song. It's also a cowboy song. Well, instead of trying to explain all that to you, I think I'll just sing it. It's called The Greatest Cowboy of Them All. I have always had my heroes. I've loved a lot of legends. In my mind a riding tall, but my cowboy hero hats off to the man who rode the donkey. He's the greatest cowboy of them all. He loves all his little doggies. He speaks to them kind and gently, and he'll lift up any maverick that falls. He sees every stray that scatters like it's the only one that matters. He's a great. Some return in sunrise. He'll call up all the riders in the sky. I gotta get my roll together, getting ready for that sunrise that winds up where old cowboys never die. Trail he rides is narrow, but it's straighter than an arrow, and he rides points for all the great and small. He will take us through the wire, right on to the plane that's higher. He's a straighter than an arrow, and he rides points for all the great and small. He will take us through the wire, right on to
thought before I play a banjo tune, I was practicing backstage and I wanted to show you a card trick. Do you mind?
Oh, okay, go ahead.
Okay, just think of any card you want, and don't tell anyone what it is. Just concentrate on it, okay? Got it? All right, here we go. Six of clubs, right?
You're right, six of clubs. That's great.
Thank you. Thank you. And just so people know, we're not playing a joke on them. Tell the people that we did not rehearse this ahead of time and just...
But Steve, we did plan it ahead of time. I did have knowledge of the card. You know,
Johnny, you're not supposed to tell them that. I mean, this is a magic trick. I mean, I look like an idiot out here. It would have been great, and now they know.
I can't lie to the people.
Johnny, it's not lying. In rehearsal, you said that you would say that we did not rehearse the trick. Now, this makes me look bad.
But you said it with such force, Steve. It was different from rehearsal. I would really have to lie if I said it out here. Rehearsal is different.
Well, so what if you have to lie? I mean, what's lying in today's world? It's nothing. I mean, come on. It's hardly even wrong.
Well, Steve, it's a Christmas show, and don't you think it would be a terrible example for my little 8-year-old boy to hear me lie on television? I mean, why don't you just play the banjo, okay?
No, I'm not going to play the banjo until you tell these people that we did not plan that trick ahead of time. I'm looking bad out here.
I can't do that. That would be lying, and when one person tells a lie, that makes it okay for everybody to lie.
No, it doesn't. Not in a magic trick. Now, look, I am not going to play the banjo until you tell these people that we did not prearrange that magic trick. Now, go on.
You will?
Yes, we'll I will play the banjo. Yes.
We didn't prearrange the magic trick.
Okay.
Okay, Steve. Okay, play the banjo.
No, you lied. Fib, but you lied, and once one guy starts lying, that's okay for everybody. That's why I said I would play the banjo, because I was lying, so that's it. I mean, if you want to lie, that's okay. That's not for me. That's not my way. Lying is not for me. I'm sorry. That's it.
Thank you. Thank you. An experience that almost cannot be put into words greets a person of faith when he visits the Holy Land. My family and my friends have made that trip several times now and plan to do it again. It's a wellspring experience for everyone. In a sense, it's like going home. And it can be a centuries-old expression for a young boy like John Carter Cash to return to the place where a fisher of men worked his miracles 2,000 years ago. And the storied Wailing Wall conjures up the drama of man's griefs and hopes over countless years. The future of the troubled Middle East is mirrored in many young faces, and the odd mixture of old and new in the city of Jerusalem cannot hide the important history that is the Holy Land. The landlocked Dead Sea symbolizes this land from which came one man who changed the world in a flowering of the spirit as brilliant as the beauty of a rose. Right now, I'd like you to meet our six daughters. Carlene, Tara, Roseanne, Cindy, Kathy, and Rosie. For the first time, our family comes to a Christmas without Mother Maybelle Carter. June's mother and a member of that trio, the Carter family, became the first family of country music over 50 years ago. Mother Maybelle loved the spiritual songs. They recorded a lot of them. And they love the songs of Christmas. And we'd like to dedicate this one to Mother Maybelle Carter.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright. Child,
Thank you. My friends and my family join me in sending you an early wish for a merry and a blessed Christmas. Good night and God bless you.
White Christmas, the white Christmas, every time I go to school.
Hey, Andy Kaufman,
hello.
Hi.
Yes. Hi.
My goodness, I'm June Carter Cash.
Really? Does that mean that you are June Carter Cash?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, uh-huh. But does that mean that your husband is Johnny Cash?
Yes, he is.
Oh, really?
Sure.
Well, you know, he is my favorite singer, and I am so happy to be here on his television Christmas special.
Well, he'll be really proud to hear that, but I think he'd like to hear it from you, you know? Why don't you tell him? You could just go over there and knock on his door and just walk right in there and tell him yourself.
Really? And just walk in and tell him?
Yeah.
And knock on the old door?
Knock on the old door, Andy.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Oh, bye. I'm going to meet the Johnny Cash. Oh, I cannot wait. Hello, Johnny Cash. You know, you are my favorite singer, and I am so happy to...
No, what? I'm not Johnny Cash. I'm Tom T. Hall.
Oh. Well, then why don't you close the door? Why do you open the door if you're not Johnny Cash? Open the door. Oh, it must be this one. Right. Hello, Johnny Cash. Hello, Johnny Cash. Hello. Hi, Johnny Cash. Oh, what have they done to you, Johnny Cash?
Well, I'm not Johnny Cash. I'm Ann Murray.
Why? Why, because you are Ann Murray?
Sure.
Is it because you're not Johnny Cash?
Sure.
Yeah, because you understand what I'm talking about? You know? Well, if she is not Johnny Cash, and he is not Johnny Cash, and I am not Johnny Cash, then who is Johnny Cash?
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky. For he saw the riders coming hard, and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi-yo, yippee-yi-yo. Those riders in the sky. Faces gaunt, their eyes were blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught them yet. Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. All the horses snorting fire as they ride on, hear their cry. As the rider sloped on by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell riding on our range, then cowboy, change your ways. If they are with us, you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-i-oh.
It's a Johnny Cash Christmas. Starring Johnny Cash with June Carter Cash and the Tennessee Three, with guest stars Andy Kaufman and Tom T. Hall, and special guest star Ann Murray.
Good evening and welcome to our annual Christmas show, and it's pretty special with Ann Murray, who remembers Christmas in Nova Scotia, Tom T. Hall, whose earliest Christmases were in Kentucky, and Andy Kaufman, who had his own special Christmases in his native country, wherever that is. My own recollections go back to my home in Dyess, Arkansas, D-Y-E-S-S, Dyess. Just recently, my father, Ray Cash, and my older brother, Roy, returned to Dyess, and they remembered an incident that later was to inspire a song that I wrote.
Well, this is our old home place. It don't look like it did back 35 years ago, does it?
Roy, you remember that great Mississippi River flood back in 1937? If you remember, all this area here was covered in water. You remember the willow trees that grew along that drainage ditch there?
I sure do.
And the old chickens roosting in the willow trees? That was a terrible flood, and all of my land was covered, if you remember, up to this part of the house, right along here, just under the floor.
I know it lacked about 4 inches getting in the house.
How high is the water, Mama? 2 feet high and rising. How high is the water, Papa? She said it's 2 feet high and rising. But we can make it to the road in a homemade boat. That's the only thing we got left at a float. It's already over all the wheat and oats. 2 feet high and rising.
I know we had to go in a boat from the house out to the road, and I think then they had a truck that brought us up here to our community building then.
But we got into center up here, and Mr. Stanbury had gone ahead with the cows and mules, you know, taking them center, and then they carried them out to Bassett.
How high is the water, Mama? 4 feet high and rising. How high is the water, Papa? She said it's 4 feet high and rising. Hey, come look through the window pane. The bus is coming, gonna take us to the train. Looks like we'll be blessed with a little more rain. 4 feet high and rising.
I remember during that flood helping Mama and Johnny and Jack and Reba out to the road because they couldn't get out without help. As much water.
Yeah. We was gone till the 16th of February. Those chickens came in the house, and when we came home, in February, we walked in the house. Of course, the doors are still open. Our hog and her 5 pigs had been in the house, and we had a couch we hadn't had very long, and that couch was covered with hen eggs.
Yes,
you remember that?
I remember it very well, yes.
How high is the water, Mama? 5 feet high and rising. How high is the water, Papa? She said it's 5 feet high and rising. Well, the rails are washed out north of town. We gotta head for higher ground. Can't come back till the water goes down. 5 feet high and rising. Well, it's 5 feet high and rising. Oh, thank you very much. Here is a Christmas present for all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely voice of Ann Murray.
I cried a tear, you wiped it dry. I was confused, you cleared my mind. I sold my soul, you bought it back for me and held me up and gave me dignity. Somehow you needed me, you gave me strength to stand alone again, to face the world out on my own again. You put me high upon a pedestal, so high that I could almost see eternity. Thank you, John.
I really love your singing.
Thank
that was
you.
Great.
Thank you very much. Thank you. For my song, I would like to do for you now a song.
Andy, wait a minute. What are you doing here?
I come to do my song, Christmas song.
Well, why don't you do it a little bit later?
Yes, but I thought I could come out here and do my song. It's a very beautiful song.
Well, I'm sure it is, but Andy, you know Andy?
Yes, we've met. He thought I was you.
Yeah, I was very stupid.
Oh, not really.
You know, Miss Marie, I think you are very beautiful.
Thank you.
So, you know, Christmas is always a lonely time for me because I am so far away from my country and I have no family, no wife, and no children. So could you do me a favor, please?
Sure.
Could you marry me and have my children?
Well, you see, I'm married, Andy, and I have two children.
Oh.
Already.
Oh.
Well, now, don't be disappointed. I think you're a really sweet guy, and I'd like to continue this relationship as friends. How would that be?
Okay, thank you very much.
Fine, you're
okay.
Welcome.
Okay, bye-bye. Could bye I bye. Come back later to do later. My song?
Oh, yes, please do.
Okay, thank
yes.
you very much.
Thank
okay,
you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
There's a choir outside of my house singing Silent Night. For any little thing that's gone wrong, Christmas makes it right. Children are singing Christmas carols and everybody's holding hands. We've got that Christmassy feeling again.
Singing joy to the world. Here comes Santa Claus.
Mama's baking turkey.
And Daddy's making popcorn balls.
Sister's hanging mistletoe.
There's goodwill to all men.
We've got that Christmassy feeling again.
Take it.
My brother Tommy wrote this and he brought it down this key for me here now. There's happiness in my heart with Christmas on its way. With the family all back together again. Oh, what a happy day. I hope it snows and the north wind blows. My boy wants a little toy train. I've got that Christmassy feeling again. Singing joy to the world. And here comes Santa Claus.
Mama's baking turkey.
And Daddy's making popcorn balls.
Sisters hanging mistletoe.
There's goodwill to all men.
We've got that Christmassy feeling again.
Singing joy to the world.
And here comes Santa Claus.
Mama's baking turkey.
And Daddy's making popcorn balls.
Sisters hanging mistletoe.
There's goodwill to all men.
We've got that
Christmassy feeling again.
We've got that Christmassy feeling again. I want to do something special now, especially for one person, and this is for the lady sitting right there, my mother, Mrs. Ray Cash. It's for you, Mama. For you, Mama, and for your sister, Edna, down in Fordyce, Arkansas, and all of our friends and neighbors in Arkansas. The moving Edna St. Vincent Millay poem, The Ballad of the Harp Weaver. Son, said my mother when I was knee-high, you've need of clothes to cover you and not a rag have I. There's nothing in this house to make a boy's breeches, nor shears to cut a cloth with, nor thread to take stitches. Nothing in this house but a loaf and a fry and that harp with a woman's head that nobody will buy. And she began to cry. That was in the early fall, and when came the late fall, son, she said, the sight of you makes your mother's blood crawl. Little skinny shoulder blades sticking through your clothes, and where you get a jacket from, God above knows. It's lucky for me, lad, that your father's in the ground and can't see the way I let his son go around. And she made a queer sound. Well, that was in the late fall, and when winter came, I'd not a pair of breeches nor a shirt to my name. Couldn't go to school nor out of doors to play. And all the other little boys passed my way. But, son, said my mother, come climb on my lap, and I'll chafe your little bones while you take a nap. And all but we were silly for half an hour or more, me with my long legs dragging on the floor, a rock, rock, rocking to a Mother Goose rhyme. Oh, we were happy for half an hour's time. But there was I, a great boy, and what would folks say to hear my mother singing me to sleep all day in such a daft way? Men say the winter was bad that year. Fuel was scarce, food was dear.
A wind with a wolf's head howled about our door, and we burned up the chairs and sat upon the floor. All that was left us was a chair that we couldn't break, and that harp with a woman's head that nobody would take for song or pity's sake. The night before Christmas, I cried with the cold. I cried myself to sleep like a two-year-old. And in the deep night, I felt my mother rise and stare down upon me with love in her eyes. And then I saw my mother sitting on that one good chair, a light falling on her from, I couldn't tell where. But looking 19, not a day older, and that harp with a woman's head leaned against her shoulder, and her thin fingers moving in the thin, tall strings were weaving wonderful things. And many bright threads from where I couldn't see were running through the harp strings rapidly. And gold threads whistled through my mother's hands, and I saw a web grow and a pattern expand. And she wove a child's jacket, and when it was done, she laid it on the floor and wove another one. She wove a red cloak so regal to see. She's made that for a king's son, I said. It couldn't be for me. But I knew it was for me. She wove a pair of breeches, and quicker than that, she wove a pair of boots and a little cocked hat. She wove a pair of mittens. She wove a little blouse. She wove all night long in that still, cold house. And she sang as she worked, and the harp strings spoke. But her voice never faltered, and the thread never broke. But when I awoke, there sat my mother with that harp against her shoulder, looking 19, not a day older, a smile about her lips and a light about her head, but her hands were on the harp strings, frozen dead. And piled up beside her and toppling to the skies were the clothes of a king's son, just my size. This is my very favorite songwriter. He's a great one. The storyteller, Tom T. Hall.
Thank you. Well, you know, folks, Christmas is really a time for children. And on this special holiday program, I'd like to do something just for the kids in the audience. I don't even need Bill Walker and the band for this. This is especially and only for the children. And of course, we have a song for you. Why, you know you can't live in the water. Why, you just be wet all the time. Your hands would get wrinkled and your face would turn blue, and you'd wind up on somebody's line. And that's why you can't be a fish. Water is not what you do. That's why you can't be a fish. That's why you have to be you. Why, you know you can't live in the air. Why, you'd be in the clouds all the time. You'd get dizzy from being so high, and you must have wings if you fly. So that's why you can't be a bird, 'cause flying is not what you do. That's why you can't be a bird. That's why you have to be you. Why, you know you can't live in a tree. Well, for one thing, the trees are too tall, and there's nothing to eat in a tree, and there's always a chance you could fall. So that's why you can't be a squirrel. Climbing is not what you do. That's why you can't be a squirrel. That's why you have to be. Ah, but it's okay to be you.
Just being yourself, you'll go far. It's really okay to be you. I love you the way you are. Ain't we great?
Tom T. Hall. That was great. I'm really glad you could be with us, buddy. I just love your work. I love your singing, your writing.
My yeah. pleasure.
Excuse me. All right?
Yeah.
All right?
Not again, Andy.
But I want to sing my Christmas song.
You
said I could come back and sing my Christmas song.
But I didn't
song.
Mean right now, you know, Tom T. Hall.
Well,
but I wanted you,
bit,
Tom
it?
T. Hall. Tom T. Hall?
Yes, sir.
I wanted you to hear it because you are a songwriter.
Well, maybe one chorus.
All right.
What do you think, John?
Well, yeah, okay.
Okay, okay. Keep it on the cozy pillow, keep it on the cozy bow. Chaba lay the bicycle, baja de la vizzy ba. Keep it on the bicycle, bole pillow, keep it on. Keep it on the bole, keep it on the ba. Everybody sing. Yabba tole bicycle, keep it on the cozy bow. Keep it on the cozy bow, keep it on the moshe pillow, keep it on the cozy bow. Keep it on the bole, keep it on. It's good?
It's different, definitely.
Definitely different.
Okay. Now, can I come back later and do some imitations?
Yes, sure, anything you'd like, Andy.
Okay.
I'd love to have you.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Country is sitting on the back porch, listening to the whippoorwills late in the day.
Country is what you make it. Country is all in your mind.
How old do you think I am, he said. And I said, well, I didn't know. He said, you know, I turned 65 about 11 months ago. I was sitting in Miami pouring blended whiskey down when this old gray black gentleman was cleaning up the lounge. Well, there wasn't anyone around except this old guy who ran the bar was watching Hee-Haw on TV. And uninvited, he sat down and he opened up his mind on old dogs and children and watermelon wine.
I remember the year that Clayton Delaney died. Well, they say for the last 2 weeks that he suffered and cried. But it laid a big impression on me. Although I was a barefoot kid, they said he got religion at the end, and I'm glad that he did.
Well, you know, Clayton was the best guitar picker in our town. I thought he was a hero. I used to follow Clayton around. Old Clayton used to tell me, son, you better put that old guitar away. He said there ain't no money in it. It'll lead you to an early grave.
Yeah, I remember the year Clayton Delaney died. Nobody ever knew it, but I went out in the woods and I cried. I know there's a lot of big preachers, they know a lot more than I do. It could be that the good Lord likes a little picking too.
Oh, I hope so.
I remember the year that Clayton Delaney died. I
honest open smiles, kisses from a child, the ladies on the dial, and then the purple ones.
I love winners when they cry, losers when they try, music when it's good, and laugh. And we love you too.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's my lady, June Carter Cash. June and I, like all of you, getting ready for Christmas. And by the way, I wonder, did you find somebody to play Santa Claus at John Carter School this year?
Well, John, you know, I just know who it's going to be.
Now, wait a minute. I'm not going to do it again this year. Every year you make me
do. I mean, I have a perfect Santa Claus. Not you. It's not you at all.
Well, you better be good. You better be good.
He's agreed to do it already. Yeah, he's going to be good. You just see for yourself.
Well, you better be.
Here. See? Now, here comes my Santa Claus. See? I got it. Here he comes. See? Now, hey, come on. See here? This is my Santa Claus. Now, come on, Santa. Come on, Santa Claus. Say what you're supposed to say. Say
please
it.
Pass the salt.
Oh, no.
Can I have a drink of water?
No, it's Merry...
Oh, Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho.
It's good.
I love it. You
like it?
Hey, you don't forget to sing Jingle Bells, too. Sing Jingle Bells.
Jingle Bells. I'm going to be rehearsing it now. I'm going to sing Jingle Bells. Okay. Yeah? Okay. So thank you. So, Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho.
Okay. All right. Jingle Bells all the way.
Jingle Bells.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Jingle Bells all the way.
Oh, I mean. You're singing right. Good. Oh.
Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho.
Hey, June. Let's just sing, all right? If I were a carpenter and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby?
If you were a carpenter and I were a lady, I'd marry you anyway. I'd have your baby.
Save your love through loneliness. Save your love through sorrow. Gave you my onlyness. Give me your tomorrow. If I were a miller and a mill wheel grinding, would you miss your colored dress and your soft shoes shining?
If you were a miller at a mill wheel grinding, and I miss my colored dress or my soft shoes shining.
Save your love through loneliness. Save your love through sorrow. Give you my onlyness. Give me your tomorrow. If a tinker was my trade, would I still find you?
I'd be carrying the parts you made, following behind you.
If I worked my hand in wood, would you still love me?
I'd answer you, yes I would.
Would you not be above me? Save your love through loneliness. Save your love through sorrow. Gave you my own. Give me your tomorrow. Thank you very much. You know, Elvis Presley once said that of all of the Elvis imitators, the one that he enjoyed the most is our guest, Andy Kaufman. Andy Kaufman. Welcome, Andy.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Andy, what do you want this
well,
time?
I would like to do for you some imitations. Okay.
But you already did an imitation of Santa Claus, remember?
Yeah, but that was stupid because I was wearing the red suit, and you know anyone can do it. Could do that. All you do is you say ho ho ho.
Oh, you do, huh?
Yeah, you Merry Christmas.
Oh, you do.
Yeah. You know, but this time I have imitations. It's better.
Oh well, good. I'd like to see you do them.
Okay. First, I'd like to do for you Johnny Cash. I'd like to do Johnny Cash.
Imitation of me?
Yeah, Johnny Cash.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Johnny Cash. Okay, bye-bye, thank you. Now I'd like to do the Minnie Pearl. Howdy. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And now last but not to be the least, I would like to do for you the Elvis Presley.
First record I ever made, I had to pay $4 to make it. I was walking down the street, it was a record store that said anyone can make a record. So I went in there and I made it for my mom's birthday, and one side was called My Happiness, and the other side was a ballad, and later became a big record for me on RCA Victor Records. It was called That's When Your Heartaches Begin, and it went something like this.
If you find your sweetheart, he'll be on the line.
Thank you.
That's when your heart aches begin. When of a lifetime must come to an end. That's when your heart aches begin.
If you find your sweetheart, in the arms of your best friend, brother. That's when your heart aches. Begin. You know, when all your dreams, when all your dreams of a lifetime must all come to an end. Yeah, that's when your heart aches. Begin. For you see, love is a thing. That you never can share. And when you bring a friend into your love affair,
back home in Dyess, Arkansas, a big part of our Christmas life was getting together and singing. As Pastor Carl Appling remembers,
after the program, we would always sing quite a few songs, such as Silent Night, Holy Night, and Old Little Town of Bethlehem, and Noel, and several other songs. Just have a good social time together.
Let's end our Christmas show in the same way, with John Carter Cash's schoolmates, Togetherness, and singing Tom T. Hall, starting it off.
Christmas is Jesus and people and things. Christmas is something the whole world can sing. Christmas is finding your enemies and friends, starting all over again. Up in the air there are reindeer and sleigh. Down on the ground there are 12 Christmas days. Christmas is there in your heart where it lives, and that's what Christmas is. Christmas is doing the best that you can. People who know Christmas will understand. Christmas is all in your heart, it's a fact, and that's where Christmas is at. Up in the air there are reindeer and sleigh. Down on the ground there are 12 Christmas days. Christmas is there in your heart where it lives, and that's what Christmas is. Christmas is giving and living in love. Christmas is praising the powers above. Show me a smile and a heart that is true. Hey, have I got a Christmas for you?
Wonder about the riddle. What kind of spirit lives in a fiddle? Well, that's old Satan right there waiting. Or are you tuned with the angel band? Well, you back up and push back off. Sing that glory and you can't go wrong. Sing in the sun, back up and push your way.
If you let the devil play on your senses, prepare to suffer the consequences. The fullest measure of the worldly pleasure can only drag you to the roaring fire. Yeah, you back up and push, back up and push, back off from sin and glory.
If I could have three wishes, and if my first wish came true, there'd be peace on earth, goodwill among men, love in all that we do.
Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair I hung my head. There is no peace on earth, I said. For hate is strong that mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then peal the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doth he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail. With peace on earth, goodwill to men. Christmas is universal, and it's very personal. It's toys, trees, and a turkey. It's a fat man in a red suit. It's a holy baby in swaddling clothes. It's a day, a season, a state of mind, and it's a wish for peace and goodwill. With those things in mind, we say thank you, God bless you, Merry Christmas, and good night.